Hello, my name is Thomas Riele and I am application engineer at Volta Machines. In this tutorial, I will show you some functions and benefits of our tool IMS Plus, using a standard cutter as an example.
Using a standard tool, we would like to explain IMS Plus in more detail. IMS Plus operations are created with Add. Then we select Probing. First, we measure the core diameter, but the order does not matter. This operation requires a base operation. In this case, there is only one possible base operation, fluting. So, we select this one. Here, we could still change the name if we want to. Then, to complete this task, we select Done. The next operation we create is the diameter measurement. This measurement requires two base operations, a chip space base operation, and a circumference base operation. We select the first clearance angle circumference as a circumference base operation, followed by Done. Now we set these two operations. First, we move the measuring points a little bit to the back, because here they run into the face chip space. Then, here the angle under which the probe moves into the chip space. 20 millimeters is fine. Here we define how far apart the measuring points are. This depends on the shape of the chip space. Then, the measurement front, or user defined. Here we vary the C-axis position. This has no influence on the measuring points on the workpiece. And here, still the weighting. How strongly a measured deviation is corrected. At 100%, the correction would have to be a 1-to-1 effect on the diameter or length of the wheel. Normally, however, one corrects somewhat less. We suggest 80%. An important point is the compensation type. We can correct the diameter of the disc with IMS Plus, or correct the length in Z, or both. For the core diameter, it is a good idea to correct the disc diameter. That is, IMS measures the core diameter and 80% of the detected deviation goes into the slice diameter as a correction. Here is the setting of the basic parameters. The core diameter 7.2 mm is the nominal value. With the offset, we could now still match a deviation of the measurement result of the probe to a measurement at an external measuring device. With OTC, we define the importance of the entered tolerance. 0 means it is corrected to the nominal value. At 100 plus, to the upper tolerance. At 100 minus, to the lower tolerance. Then, the plausibility factor. This defines the validity range of the measured value. 2 means a doubling of tolerance limits. If the measured value is within these limits, it influences the calculation of the correction. If it is outside, it is not considered. Thus, measurement outliers have no influence. Next, the diameter measurement. The diameter measurement corresponds to a throat gauge measurement. This means that the measurements are first taken at one position and then at the opposite position. The determined values are used for the correction. Here we would like to correct the length in Z at the disc. Again, the same settings as for the core measurement. When the diameter measurement has run through and the tool has detected a deviation, then the deviation is entered in the slice data. We simulate this here. For length in Z, a deviation of 0.01 millimeters. Now you see here at the first and second clearance angle circumference, in the correction table in column plus minus, a green bar. IMS Plus knows from the assignment we originally made that the correction applies to this slice. Since the slice element radius is selected for the circumference of the first clearance angle, IMS Plus knows that the correction value must be entered here. In all operations that work with the same grinding wheel as the first clearance angle circumference and with the same wheel part setting, the length Z is now corrected. We have prepared a small graphic here. All operations that work with the radius are now compensated. There is still the setting side, which in this case could be the face of the wheel. It doesn't change anything significant in the display now. But here, side is now the reference surface. If we could change to circumference, this surface is now the reference. Of course, this does not work in this case. So we change back to radius. As you can see, here is the green bar again. If we do not want to compensate at all, this can be deselected here. As you have seen, it is also possible to enter the values manually. So we can also use the corrections manually without IMS. IMS Plus has the advantage that the individual measuring operations can be inserted several times. For example, if one has to compensate different grinding wheels for different step diameters. If an IMS Plus measurement is followed by another grinding operation in which the corrected grinding wheel is used, the correction takes effect immediately. However, the underlying base operation must have been ground beforehand.
I hope this tutorial can help you in your work with our machines. My colleagues and I will be happy to answer any questions you may have. You can find the contact details in the video description. Thanks for watching and best of success.